I today one way tear down of this. We have here a very sad Sokisha set for a total station. So not sure what happened here, but you can see it is very badly oxidized of aluminium oxide. It is falling in powder, this thing. I guess the battery did leak and it was in the storage case horizontally, and the battery did leak over everything and corrode all the aluminium. You have problems here, even on this side, it is oxidized. Also, if this axis is still more or less turning, this one is completely stuck and the controls here are stuck. So we can expect a lot of problems in this compartment. First, we will have an overall look at the device. So it is early 90s vintage total station from the Sokisha brand that became later Sokia. And this model is very common and famous and still quite expensive actually. So, little bit of a close-up. As all total station, well, most of them, you have actually two control panels. You have clamp, tripod or tri-brack adapter. You have a clamping mechanism to secure in each axis, horizontal and vertical. And you have a laser telemeter here with an extra control panel for, I believe, temperature compensation of a laser telemeter, something like this. Main optics, a little bit of a viewfinder. And on the other side goes the big optics, built-in battery, some terminals for data output. And actually, the adapter here at the bottom is not too bad. One might be possible to reuse. Not too oxidized, and here we have already the Sokia brand. A little bit of a problem here, but should be worse. And you can see already some aluminium powder. As most of the total stations, you have optical plummet that will go down at the middle here, and you can actually shine a light in here if I find my light, by the way. If I shine a light here, you can see there is a wall optical path coming here at the bottom. Okay, even here at the bottom, some white powder of oxide. So we can expect some difficulties to take this apart. It will be obviously a one-way teardown because I will not keep an item in this condition. Look at this. This side is really bad. Wow. Even here in the middle, I did already clean it a little bit, but it was worse when I did receive it. Okay, I will start by undoing this battery BDC18, which we did obviously. It seems fail quite badly. So to remove this battery, it might be quite stuck because obviously it is missing here the release button. So precision tool. Oh, Quai irrisve condition of it? Yes, obviously, it did leak. Remains of a case. And okay, you get the idea. Already a lot of white powder falling everywhere. Little cover here with the remains of a piezo speaker. And already we have the first view at the internal condition of the thing. This side seems quite bad. It is where my blocked mechanism is. But you know what? A lot of white powder here already. Look at this. Look at this here. Wow. Not good, not good, not good. But I know the polarity of the battery, so why not try to power it on? Let's do something completely crazy. The worst that can happen is a fire or explosion, so not a big deal. Let's try to power it on and see if anything happens. I will try to connect two banana plugs here. I will turn it in a, well, no matter the direction, this one. And try to see if anything will happen on the control panel. Let's give it 7 volts, something like this. And suspense. Okay. This part here is making a noise, or maybe it is a speaker. Yes, it is a speaker actually. But we have something on the display at least. So it is not totally dead. Interesting. Other things on the other display. But it looks like it does not respond to any of the buttons. No, doesn't do anything. Little encoder wheels here. Quite interesting. But it is, they are so dirty, it is not possible almost to see the numbers inside. Okay. At least it is doing something. Quite fun, and already a lot of white powder on my bench. Okay, I will cut the power for the very last time to this thing. And I am thinking about how to proceed. How to proceed. You know what? So first, I can maybe undo this. Not necessary to keep. Okay. But I will start on this side. Oops. To see first the least damaged side. It will give an overview of how bad it could probably be in the other side. So let's start here. Then I will probably undo the control panels, progress towards the other side, and see if it is possible to remove this telemeter part to have a look in the second part of the video. Okay, let's do it. So you will notice we have slotted screws in here. So on this side I did already probe the screws and I know they are not too badly stuck. So let's do it. Ah, screwdriver is too big. It is always the same thing with slotted screws. Sometimes quite difficult to find the correct size of screwdriver. Apparently we have brass screws in aluminium die-cast body, which is already a bad idea because if you mix together yellow and white metal with any moisture, it will make some electrolyte action and like a battery in fact, and may get oxidized. So this cover, I did already undo it previously to reveal internal condition. You can see it is already very bad. And in here we have a circuit board with oxidized screws here on the top. An interesting module here, not sure what it is. And look at this. Wow. Okay, so this side is already not terribly impressive about the status. I got this item for 30 British pounds, by the way. I paid more in shipping than for the item itself. Okay, I can see probably here we have the rotary encoder for the horizontal axis with nice golden photodiodes or LEDs in here, so good already. Flat cables here, which apparently can be probably, yes, disconnected directly like this, with little sockets embedded directly in the circuit board. Okay, it will allow me to undo, I believe, the control panels. It looks like we have screws at this level. So, for this purpose, I need to access the screws. It looks like we might have hidden screws behind those stickers. Yes, I was right. I am always right, by the way. Oops, try not to stab myself. Should be good. Very old stickers here. Very sticky. But I now have access to what seems to be screws securing this. Six of them. And this screwdriver is not good at all. Let me check another one. No. I might need to get the precision screwdrivers. Okay. I do not know yet how many stuck screws I will encounter, but I did already charge my drill. In the case, I have to drill some of them. Not sure if this one is coming. We will probably find a lot of more white powder. It is a luck the customs did not control this parcel for suspicious powders, if you see what I mean. Okay, do you believe it will come off? Almost. Almost. But this one here, we have a stock screw here already, I believe. Okay. I was able to break the plastic here. Anyways, this thing is not coming together anytime soon. Again. Not sure why here it is not coming. Yes, I really need to undo these screws completely. Try to. This one, it is weird. I turn, but nothing happens. Okay. First control panel is off. Obviously, a very common controllers here for LCD display. Two little yellow LEDs inside. So they will be lit from the side, apparently. These things. The screw is loose here at the back. Maybe it is when I did pull. Nothing here. Except the screws poking through, it seems, for the display, for the keyboard. Yes, like that. Regular carbon membrane keyboard with golden contacts here. Four screws, two little LCDs. Okay. Let's put it aside. I will throw away some of the screws which are not worth keeping. And you can see in here, yes, more white powder and more decaying aluminium. Nothing else to see here. Bubble level. Okay, let's undo the other side the same way. This sticker here is hanging. Let me grab something more dangerous, like a cutter. Okay. Okay. And screwdriver. It is exactly the same configuration of screws in the other direction. So far, not too bad. I expect to find behind this panel access to the main vertical axis rotary encoder. So I hope I will be able to salvage some interesting parts or find anything interesting in this, at least. Not sure yet. So far, the electronics seem pretty common, typically Japanese, except maybe for this black module here. Okay, so same deal here, except the screws are not rusty, these ones. But you can see damage on the circuit board. More white powder. And nothing to see here. So it seems all the access to the encoder would be from the bottom, apparently. Some more white powder to undo. Okay. Now, you know what? Before I continue, a little bit of cleaning on the bench, I believe. Because already I will keep the brass screws for the scrapyard. Okay. So now we can I will keep this stand as long as possible because it is more convenient, obviously, but let's try to undo this side. And here I see something annoying. We have two screws at the bottom which could be possible to undo. But we have two screws here in the middle that seem to be really, really bad. Ah, this one is turning. Nice. But this one here, I am not sure what to do with it. Okay, I know what to do. Give me 1 second. Drill time. Luckily, they are brass, so probably. Not too hard to drill. Could be good enough. So I can continue, and the screws on the top I did already undo them one time previously, actually. So it is why they are not stuck. Okay. We have a cover with a switch. Not sure if I will be able to save it. More powder. And first view for me on this side. So what do we have? Battery contacts on the top. The main ball bearing system. And actually here, rotary contacts to the telemeter piece, which is now moving a little bit. Your completely stuck clamp mechanism here, which will unscrew like such. So let's undo it. And at the bottom, nice, where I am, here. Nice ceramic hybrid circuit on this circuit board. More of the same kind of contacts. Little auxiliary, probably power supply related board here. I can see Allen screws. I can see Allen set screw here, which is probably stuck. Okay, and what else? I guess it is all for this, so let me grab Allen screwdriver and I will undo this part in order to see what happens. So obviously a lot of things to take apart in here. It will be a long video, it will not be a YouTube short, this thing. Okay, this one was not too bad. This will unscrew. With a very, very fine thread. Look at this. Wow. Okay. This piece is now loose. And I might be able to... If I am lucky, undo this screw here. This one will not be recovered, obviously. And this should allow to remove this part, but as you can guess, it will not come with very easily. It will require some WD-40 or something. Okay, what to do next? Before I undo the base plate and I put the camera over it for the teardown, what I can do next is to undo here for you this handle, two screws here which are very, very hard. So, time for the big pliers. Normally, they are thumb screws you can undo by hand, but not here. Okay. Could be worse, actually. Interesting hardware. Okay, not too bad. Die-cast aluminium part here. Big slotted screws in here. So before I put the camera over it, let's do something. First, remove from the base. Like such. So this part I will keep after cleaning. I will do this. Like such. In order to try to keep my workbench as clean as possible, well, as less dirty as possible. I did already sadly throw away some of this white powder. I would have kept everything to show the amount of white powder at the end of the video. Because I have feeling I will find more. Okay. So now what can I do next? Maybe undo this bottom here. It will be easier in this configuration for me. So, will we find more white powder in this bottom part? This is the cover to the optical plummet and rotary contacts for the connectors here that are coming from the electronics. Okay, more white powder even in here, so you can see we have some wires, rotary contacts here. We will have a better look at it later probably. Can I undo this part now? Or not? I have no ID of what will happen. I have to undo, I believe, this. Board here. Yes, it is the access to Rotary encoder, Rotary contacts, but not what I want to undo for now. This not as a string either, just cable retainers made of little things like this to keep the wires in place. So it is not what I want to undo. I need to undo those two screws. Okay. So far, could have been worse, actually. Okay, it is what I want to access. The actual wipers to the Rotary contacts. Let me grab side papers and get rid of what is not useful here. So, Rotary contact piece. Like such, they are not too bad actually. Here I see a brass piece. Wow. Probably the main mounting thing to the vertical axis. So do I undo it now or later? Good question. Let me get rid of this because it is in the way. Okay, little wipers like this. And now I can try to undo this part. Try to. Okay, one screw is off. Two screws. Wow. I am feeling lucky today. Three screws. But the last one seems... Can I clamp this thing? Really lucky. Okay. And now what is happening? Not much actually. Not much. So let me think about it. You see this brass ring here? Will it come off or not? Yes. Loose parts. What do we have here? Time for the precision tool. If you are still around in this video, thanks a lot. Because, believe me, it is not done. We have a few more things to go through. Maybe it would be good if I undo those Allen screws. Do you think so? Or this clamping mechanism at least here. Not sure which one I must undo first. This can go off. Same deal than the other one. Apparently. Maybe, maybe not. Yes, hours of unscrewing. Not what I was expecting, so I must attack now here. No clue of what I will get in this thing. I hope the laser telemeter things will be interesting. Usually you have in them you have fiber optics. Check my two other total station teardowns. It is number 3 and actually there is number 4 which is coming. It will be a Nikon one. Ah, it does help obviously, even if it is not totally good yet. Not sure why, excuse me. No extra screw, no. There is something maintaining it, and it seems to be actually this part here. Will it come off or not? Yes. Okay. Little bit better. Okay, we are good. So here the remains of a clamping mechanism. It was still working, but as you can see, not very clean. Even very dirty. Very dirty wires in here. Going just over two plugs here, no, no electronics. Nice brass slotted screws here. And this pins to secure to the base plate. Okay, it is a little bit better. But now it is not coming because I believe I have to access from the other side, but you can see very nice brass piece here. Very impressive. Okay. So now I can put the camera overhead. So real quick, one last look at this part. Look at it carefully because it is the last time ever you are seeing it. Old wires, some nice brass screws. I will clean it correctly before sending to the scrapyard to separate all the metals. Serial number here for those playing at home. Of a device. Okay, let's get rid of it. Now, where to start in here? We will start with something easy, maybe. This optical plumette. Ah, I did just wash my hands, like 30 seconds ago. This does just unscrew. And we have here the eye adjustment and apparently center focusing, center alignment of optics with those interesting screws fitted with all of the side, like safety screws on aircraft equipment. I am not sure how far I will be able to undo it. Actually, I see set screws here at the bottom, but I cannot reach them for now. So let's start with the less damaged side. More flat cables to undo. I believe this board should come off quite easily if the screws are not stuck. I really need to make sure I am recording, because it is obviously not a video. I can shoot twice. Oops. Okay, nice golden board-to-board pins here. So nothing special on this board. Regular parts from the... Do I have a dead code somewhere? Yes. 89. But this is an interesting part. Not sure what it is. Not sure if it is soldered on the board or socketed. No, it is soldered. Looks like some custom part. Branded, Sokia or Sokisha, you can see. Well, the remains of it. Maybe an hybrid module or some sensor for horizontality or something like this. And those very annoying embedded contacts. Okay, so we access to a second level of circuit board. Which is clamped here at the bottom, so I have to undo two screws on the top. Do we have anything good? Okay. It is a shame it is in this condition. But first you can see one more Sokisha branded custom module. Sokisha hybrid here. ADC, National Semiconductor. Supercapacitor, but here we have very, very, very rare piggyback processor, you can see. Wow, it is oxidized, this thing. I might need to put it in, probably in vinegar to clean it. Not sure what it will do. So it is actually a microprocessor with its EEPROM directly installed over it. Very rare, and I believe it is the first time I see one. So I am not sure what I will do with this board. Do I keep the whole board, put it in vinegar, or just try to solder the processor itself? I will figure it out later on. But really interesting. And not really expected. So already a good part, even if sadly it is damaged by oxidation. And here is the nice stuff. Wow. Do you see the condition here on those trimmers? It is completely oxidized, this thing. So we have apparently the board to the rotary encoders. We have one here, you can see the glass disc. We have another one here for the other axis. We have the screw to the clamp here. Let me try to undo it. Will it collaborate or not? No. See, this one is too big. Try to let me try another screwdriver. No, this one. May require some drilling. Okay. I will figure it later, not a big deal. So here we have rotary encoder, we have the probably the bearing to this axis, so not sure how to remove this part. I need to undo them, by the way, to be able to undo the wall system, but so first undo this board. Screw. Maybe we will find more interesting ICs at the back. Is this socketed or not? Not. So just cut the wires anyways. Okay. Nice. Even if the condition is not terribly good, but more custom parts. Not sure if they are hybrids or ICs or something, but anyways, they are in epoxy, so probably not easy to open. So you can see the status of the case here, very, very bad. Let me try to figure out what is going on in here. Okay. So I guess this is one single part. I have a lot of Allen screws to undo. I hope it will allow me to access easily, remove easily this ball bearing, and then the goal is obviously to undo properly the middle piece in order to be able to have a look at it without the wall case around. At least the screws here are coming off nicely. The other side might be a little bit complicated. Okay, this is good. Then not sure what to do next. Oh. It looks like it did undo by itself, but I am attached here by this clamping system. Which is totally stuck, by the way. So you know what, I will put some penetrating oil and we will go to the other side and come back to this side later on. Maybe the oil will have time to do its job and allow securing this part. So here, nothing of interest. This wall part is trying to come loose, but really secured. Or maybe I can do use more precision tools and just do this. Okay. Not sure what is going on here, but obviously you have a number of springs, rust on the main ball bearing assembly. Some electronics to these things here. So let's directly have a look at this part to get it out of the way later on, because we have two interesting things to check. The kind of diodes that are used. If it goes come off, okay. So regular gold metal case diode. Not sure if it is red or infrared. Some optical lens, and on the other side, obviously the matching pickup sensor that will read the rotary encoder. 6 photodiodes in a special package directly mounted on this embedded in this assembly of circuit board and epoxy. Overside is the same little controller board here for it, and your rotary encoder with very fine markings, little strips like this all around to allow figuring out the angle and the direction of rotation also. Okay, so I will clean a little bit this mess and we will continue. So at least it looks like I will be able to reach in here and remove the main bearing. But it is for later. Now I will undo the things on the other side. I did just clean my bench like 2 seconds ago. So here we have interesting things. Screwdriver, please, this one. First undo this board. Try to. Okay. It looks like it is hardwired to this box, which is most probably a sensor for a level sensor, something like this. So far I am lucky with the screws, really. I was expecting a lot more problems. So this board. This goes to the. This I will cut. Most probably, yes. There is a little relay, it seems, so power supply board. So here we have what seems to be an interesting sensor, which is secured. How is it secured? By 2 Allen screws. At least the Allen screws are good, not rusty. I will be able to save them. Okay. Interesting. It requires further opening, and as you can see, so probably some kind of level sensor, I guess. Will it come apart or not? I have no idea. Might come apart if I can undo here this little screw, which is completely rusty. For some reason there is this cover which is soldered to it. Kind of metal cover, cladding. Get rid of it immediately before I cut myself. and okay, it should come off. Ah, easier than expected, actually. A little cover and some. You can see it is obviously a precision piece, precisely aligned to accommodate this thing. We have a metal tube with glass vial. So yes, most probably some kind of electronic level, like I got in the pipe laser also. Really? Wow. What to do? The screws are not coming at all. Wow. Let me drill them off camera and I will be right back. Okay, actually I was able to undo the screws after clamping the part in a vise. So we have here some kind of shielding around this. Job, which I need to undo. Totally the good, the correct way to use side cutters, by the way. Okay. And well, no idea of what I will find in here. It looks like it is just magnet wire coils, three of them. Yes. So will it come off this thing? Okay. Mystery vial. I see there is some kind of a liquid inside. Not sure why it is painted in black, or actually the liquid inside is black. Is it very fluid? Wow, could be very nice. Yes, look at this. Ferrofluid. It is the first time I have some. So this is awesome. Wow. So probably it is some kind of variable adductor. A doctor transformer, something like this, that will sense the how the ferrofluid is laid around and be able to tell if it is even on all three coils or something like this. Brass or copper shielding inside here and a ferrofluid tube. So this is super, super nice. Definitely a keeper. Okay, we continue with well, you have to try to access the bearings to in order to be able to undo the telemeter part. I hope this video will not end being 3 hours long. Okay, so this side obviously is very bad. Rotary contacts here to the telemeter piece, of course. You need rotary contacts at some point. Let's undo this. This is already half loose because I didn't screw it previously. This. Okay. Oh. Actually, there is a little connector here. Quite interesting. So, next. If I want to undo this part, well, wish me luck. Good brass screws here. Not sure about this unit. Okay. Really? I am lucky today. Some shielding here for something. I have no idea what it is. Since we have a pin securing this part, but probably nothing special here. Just mechanical protection or something like this. Oops. Yes. Okay. And now, not sure which ones I have to undo here, but I will undo everything anyways. Unexpected things can happen sometimes. Okay. Wow. Did it come off this thing? Should it unscrew? I have no clue. First, finish undoing the screws. I have a feeling this one must unscrew. It is more or less loose. Let me try to do something with the big brass piece. Like that, for instance. Okay. Not sure what is going on here, but I am secured by this part. Wow. So let's try to just pry it out of the way. Big screwdrivers. You always need big screwdrivers. Excuse me. Oops. Okay, it's good. I believe it will definitely help. If I am not sure, it will clear the gap, but. Now I can do the same thing here. Well, try to. I'm not sure what is going on this side, but and let's just undo the screws to this part. So you know what? I am wondering if some saw action could help here. If I cut here, for instance, will it help to undo the whole thing? Because I want to check the bottom rotary encoder also, so. Let's be crazy and let's do it. Look at this, hidden Allen screws. I guess it will help if I undo them. It might help. I hope it will help. It should help. Whatever. It will help even more if I have the correct bit to undo them. In fact, it is always the same system they use to put this thing together. So it should definitely help a lot. Okay, so main axis part here. And now, this is a big hole going into the thing and showing stuff. Do I have the same thing here? Or is this thing screwed in some way? Or just pressed in? Maybe. Looks like it is screwed. Not easy to tell. It is definitely loose. But I am not sure if it is unscrewing or not. It must come off in order to allow to undo the telemeter part. This is what I know. Do we have more hidden Allen screws in here? It is also possible. No, I do not see anyone. This thing is annoying. Fun but annoying. Give me 1 second. Will more precision tool help? Yes, precision tools, always useful. And we are good. Nice. Wow. We are good about putting a terrible mess on my bench. This is terrible, insane. Wow. Now we have rust also, not only aluminium oxide. Okay. Excuse me, 1 second. little bit better, maybe. Very little bit better. Wow, my bench looks like a battlefield. So, you do not see what is around, believe me, it is not glorious. So, we have here the main vertical encoder to retrieve. I believe we have three covers here hiding. Probably, yes, more Allen screws that should allow me to easily undo the thing with the correct size of screwdriver, of course. I am really happy I was able to break loose this part with a bolt cutter instead of a saw. It saved me at least 10 minutes. I am not an angle grinder man, so I do not like angle grinders. They are noisy and dangerous. So, interesting noise for sure. And interesting, yes, of course, same deal than the overtime. I am stuck here with this clamping screw thing. That is this one completely stuck place. But I should be able to undo this side. Super big box of random parts. If I unscrew this, it should give enough clearance, I hope, to allow proper removal of the rotary encoder. Or not. Yes, this thing is completely stuck in here, I can see. The amount of precision tools that is needed is really insane for this teardown. So very, very clean teardown, as you can expect for precision optical device. Wow, I'm not sure what is going on here, but really, at least, all this to reveal, not much, exactly the same rotary encoder assembly. It looks like very similar, except we have no embedded electronics here, and the actual optical infrared sensor is not the same, it seems. Let me undo this one real quick. Yes, this time we have four photodiodes in a package surface mount. I can see gold bonding wires, bonding Sokilsa. Okay, in here somewhere we must have ball bearings. We have clamping mechanism, nice brass parts that will require removal. So I will do this later off camera. Nothing else to see in here. But one more thing. Prism here to the optical plumet. You can see there is one optical piece like this and right angle prism, and it is all actually. Okay, some flat cables linking the two sides together, and it is all for this poor part. One bubble level I will maybe try to retrieve, and you can see the aluminium oxide everywhere. Really, really bad. So, I will take a break, wash my hands, and then we will open the main piece of interest, the laser telemeter. Ah, nice ball bearing here. So, this part, the laser telemeter, what to do first. This thing here is still not coming off. I will need to deal with it with a hammer or Dremel, I believe. It seems to be unscrewing, but not completely yet. It looks like we have a little set screw here, which is stuck, by the way. So can I do more precision work like such? And try to remove this aluminium ring, maybe it will help. If it is not part of the main assembly. Not easy to tell, not easy to tell. I will figure it out later. We have not a set screw on the side. Really, really weird. So, not a big deal. We have little covers. We will first undo the little covers. This one for the eyepiece. So you will notice the slotted screws at the outside and for customer satisfaction probably. And regular Philips. Well, I am just lying. We have more slotted. So, eyepiece. Piece, more aluminium dust, and slotted screws securing this part. Do I undo it right now? Yes. Not sure what is going on, but it looks like in here we have oil. And it is definitely not me. I hope we have not an oil tank in this thing. Okay. Yes, a lot of iron over screws for some reason. But here, nice prism assembly. And this wall part is now unscrewing. Wow! So it is a mix of aluminium and brass, but you can see a really, really nice brass. And this nice thing. Okay, the other piece is secured inside. So, what to do next? Little covers, even if this one I do not think it will reveal anything interesting. Oh. One more buzzer. What do you need? No, two piezo speakers. Not sure. Some wires going from one side to the other one. And it is all. Okay. Here we have a little access panel. access cover for setting probably. Okay. Yes, little selector, but look at this. Do you see it? I see a gold ceramic IC in here. So it could be good. First, I will undo the other side, but I will, for my own convenience, I will remove this viewfinder thing. It will allow me to put this like so, and it will be easier. So, what do we have in this top part first? More aluminium dust, pressed aluminium sheet cover, it seems here, or die cast in one piece, not sure. Optical little viewfinder thing here. Does not show a lot. No, not really convenient, this thing. So, we have more custom hybrids, it seems. And yes, we were expecting optical fibers. Here is our optical fiber. And I see another one here. So what to do? Do I first try to undo the stuff on this side? Yes, I think so. Here we even have golden contacts on this flat flex. So obviously your precision stuff that requires good contacts. Some kind of control board here with this again this custom shape, but at least this one is clean and I might keep it like this as is. Interesting design here of securing clamp for the board with apparently little screw on the side. Okay. More optical fiber here. I need to get rid of this one also. Okay. And here we have, obviously, seems to be a laser source or something. I will undo this fiber optic connector with precision pliers. Try to. I believe it is screwed on. Seems to be screwed on, but it will be easier if I first undo this module. So this seems to be interesting, but sadly, as you can see, it is soldered in place. Ah, yes. Wow. I see one probably photodiode, so it must be some receiver module. It is quite weird. We have actually two optical fibers. Or maybe it is not an optical fiber, it is an coax. This thing, it is also possible. And I'm still not sure if it does unscrew or if it does looks like it doesn't screw, but it is actually secured with a thread lock, it seems. Wow. Okay, and it is electrical coax. Okay. So we have here annoying flat flex, as I will just cut. And this part, I guess it is the receiver side. Because of a photodiode outputting signal in an electrical signal. Let me try to deal with this welded cover. With precision tools again. Oops. Okay, could be worse, really. No blood yet. Okay, little circuit board in here with your photodiode or phototransistor. Little hybrid. A lot of tantalum caps. And it is all. So it is good. This part does not require further teardown. Let's continue with this assembly here, which seems to be interesting. Here we have an optical fiber. Which will require undoing a little set screw. Which of course is stuck. So anyways, this thing is in poor condition. I will try to extract it by force. The amount of precision work in this thing is just insane. Or just cut the thing away. Okay. So what do we have in here? Some kind of a shutter actuated by maybe this motor here, and here some kind of a secondary motor actuating this over. Okay, one shutter here to the optical fiber thing, if you can see. I'm not sure, but there is definitely an optical fiber thing in here. This is a shutter secured by one screw behind here, probably. One little prism assembly. Motor actuating this thing, which is completely rotten and stuck. Yes, completely stuck in place. Wow. And very nice, not sure why, piece here. A brass piece, counterweight or something. Okay. In here, we see more optical goodness. Actually, three standoffs, one prism assembly. So if I can undo the standoffs. I can also undo this thing, so let me deal with it real quick. Okay, the standoffs are magically off. Now I can undo the surprise m'assemblait dans une ear. Wow, it is not a Bentley anymore, it is apocalyptic. Nice prism assembly for sure. How does it work? No. The prism assembly works with light, and my light does not work anymore. Okay. Okay. Seems we have a colored filter in the top one. So really, really interesting things. So, down in here, I did damage some kind of a target here in the middle. That is now bent. There is one set screw here that will probably be very annoying and will not collaborate with me. Ah, this one I am lucky. But I do not think it will help a lot because this part is probably stuck. So now time to go to the other side, which I suspect may contain some interesting electronics. Terrible suspense. Same kind of cover. Wow, already one it is upside down, but one Sokisha apparently hybrid module. I am not able to tell if it is socketed or soldered in place. Little control panel here, more flat flex as it has come off like such. And other side, wow, that is cool, guys. One more piggyback processor, but this time it is clean. It is clean, but it is also soldered in place, it seems. Wow, very flimsy connections here, you can see. Not impressive. We have one super nice ceramic chip, Fairchild MB63107, soldered in place, it seems, sadly, yes, but these boards are not too much damage by oxide, so I might be actually able to keep them as a wall unit, but I have to figure out how to undo them. First this little control panel, I guess. Okay. Easy enough. So we'll just have here, yes, three rotary encoders, a few, what are they? Unusual little green linear ICs, five legs, maybe they are called D, so maybe they are diode networks. More. Interconnect here, and yes, just here a little control panel with one LED, the three rotary encoders, two switches, typically Japanese switches. Let's undo it. Try to. Ah, you know what? We are Rotary encoders are inserted from the outside and soldered in place. So I cannot remove the board without unsoldering the encoders. Not a big deal. Okay, so, excuse me, I will just quickly read up some hardware here. Let's say in this part. Okay, so, we have this unit that should come off in one way or another. I see two screws here. I see probably here a laser diode. So let's try to undo it. It is good this part is not too much damaged. So this board, is it coming off, this one? Could be coming off, but we have a screw here. Okay, ah, we have our optical fiber. We have one interconnect here, and other coax here, okay. So it is mounted onto a shielding or heat sink. Nice Sokisha hybrid module here, but obviously it is soldered in place. So I did not decide yet what I will do with these boards. I might at least try to open one of the hybrids, some Toyocom crystal oscillator here, nothing special. Nice aluminium plate at the back. Okay, if I open the hybrids, I will do a follow-up video with my USB microscope views of the contents of the hybrids. Okay, so does it allow a better access to the other board, because there is something else here that seems interesting. I am not sure yet how to undo these ones. Ah, okay. Okay, look at this. We have a piece here securing the two boards together, but we have a hole in the middle because there is a screw all at the bottom and another one here. So will it fit this screwdriver? Oh, barely, barely. Another one here. And it should come off after gluing some stuff here. So some wires. The remain of the optics, but nothing of major interest in here. You can see one more nice brass part at least. Main optic with a wall in the middle, actually. There is a separator in here. Can you see it? Maybe not. Excuse me. Like such. Yes, there is a wall in the middle separating the two sides. Okay. Not much else, except I still cannot undo this part here. It is quite insane. I do not see onto how it will come off. Actually, I see a thread in the middle here. I would love to now, oh, it is coming off, but really, not an easy thing. Oh, interesting, we might have some hidden set screw somewhere. Or a pin or something like this. Really, really curious. Okay, I will leave it later. Nothing else of interest in this part. So, here. Last but not least, this electronic assembly. Nice socket. Ah, this one is socketed. So I can try to first for you this piggyback thing very carefully. HD 63P01 M1 piggyback processor with its little EEPROM. If I read the EEPROM, I will put a link in the video description with contents. So this is socketed, it seems. So I should be able to lift it super carefully and see how it looks like from the bottom at least. Okay, some ceramic unit soldered all around. So it may be possible to hit the case and remove the contents. They did hide some more parts at the bottom, obviously. So this is a super nice. Definitely, if I find another one of those Sokia or Sokisha total stations in good condition, I will grab it for the collection purpose because they are nice. So those screws, I want to keep them because I will probably, I might keep this wall assembly. Just undo the useless connections here. And here we have, wow, one more weird unit. So, maybe a DC-DC converter. Here, something like this. Yes, a lot of power supply related stuff. And actually, in this big Sokia module, can I undo the sticker on this side to reveal any more useful things? I see not much. It seems to be pretty much empty, except for what seems to be a ferrite toroidal transformer or something like this. You can more or less guess on this side. Gray cylinder, and I do not see anything else on this assembly, but it is a ceramic board. So a ceramic board just for apparently a ferrite transformer seems quite weird. Okay, but this is definitely the winner part. I will clean it further. The most interesting part of the thing, I guess, together with another thing. Okay, so I hope you did enjoy this little teardown, little quick and easy teardown of this Sokisha Z4A Total Station. At least I grabbed some interesting parts from it. I was not expecting such good things actually. I was expecting very regular Japanese electronics and nothing of interest, but here it is definitely a good surprise. In particular with the, where is it? The second unit here, which is requiring some cleaning, obviously. I will try with vinegar and see what happens. Okay, so to conclude this video, a little view at the state of my bench. So excuse me, I will undo the camera from its stand over in. And here is what the bench looks like. Tools, parts, more tools, parts everywhere on the ground, parts, and totally wrong white balance. Okay, and the video would not be complete if I do not show you the white powder stuff. Wow. So I have some cleaning to do, as you can guess. Putting this in a safe place, and later on further cleaning of all the extra parts that did come off and need extra processing. A few loose parts here also. So it was really an interesting thing. And stay tuned maybe for another Total Station teardown in a few weeks. So thanks for watching. Bye bye.